Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the iconographer of this video. We are getting closer to the Orthodox Easter, and here you can see me painting Virgin Mary. This is an iconographic type of Virgin Mary lamenting for the passion of her son Jesus. Sometimes we see this type of icon, Virgin Mary with Jesus. He is dead already, and she is right next to him, lamenting and mourning her son. These days are very hard for many people. So I do hope Virgin Mary gives strength and hope to many of us. So yes, here you see me painting the first light, the face. I do hope you enjoy this content, these videos. If you find them relaxing, if you learn something, please do subscribe. More videos will follow, and it's important to me to know that people do respond to this kind of content. The more I paint and the more I do these videos, the more I learn myself. And I become better. Now that we are more at home, it's a good opportunity to do some studies and try to observe more the old icons and learn from them. This first light on the face, it's better to be thinner and more liquid. And of course use a natural bristle brush, as it makes the whole difference. Now I try to smooth the edge of the first light, make it a bit softer. Some icons have very smooth transitions from light to proplasmos, to dark. Some icons, like those in the Cretan tradition, are the transition is more hard. Some people do prefer the Cretan style icons, some people prefer the Macedonian, so-called Macedonian, or Paleologian, I don't know. Please do comment below, write me what you think, what you prefer, what you like, or if you paint, what style do you use to paint. I really like reading your comments, and I do take some strength to continue these videos. So here I paint the second light. The cretan style is using psimmythias already from the second light. Those narrow lines. Some painters are afraid these psimmythias. They are not very easy. They require a lot of concentration and a good brush and a steady hand. It's very difficult. Also, I'm always struggling. It's hard for me as well. But we are painting to learn, to become better. We're not here to make masterpieces. The hand, take your time to build the light. And give love and attention to every part of the icon. Every brush should have a reason to exist. Unfortunately, the camera I use, as I'm not a professional in recording videos, produces a result that is not as faithful to the original icon that I'm painting. The colors are a bit more dull, a bit more whitish, but you can tell, I think, what's going on in the icon. And of course, these are just studies that I do. I normally use golden leaves, and I gild the icon before I sell it to a monastery. But as these are some studies I was willing to do, I just paint on regular wood with no gold leaf. The second light is done, and now I'm doing the third light and the psimmythias, in the style of psimmythias. Again, the brush is very important, and I strongly suggest you use Kolinsky brush, as it keeps more color for longer, and you can control it so much better than anything else. Of course, the expression on the face of a saint is very important. Sometimes I see icons that technically are not the best, but the painter has given a fantastic expression on the eyes of the figure that is painted. And it's very inviting to pray, to feel as if you are in the icon. Of course, Virgin Mary here is sad. She contains her sadness. Byzantine art is all about balance and the feelings are contained. For the first light, I use titanium white, ochre, and some red. For the mouth, I use the first light, and I add some red. For the upper lip, I do some plain red. Now smithies with pure white. For smithies it's important not only the way you paint them, but also their position and the way they are positioned on the first light. Here you see me adding some light on the eyes of Virgin Mary. Sometimes iconographers forget that this is a painting as well. That an icon is not made by a robot, but it's made by a human being. Thus, brush strokes are evident, sometimes the lines are shaky. I often see icons that are extremely pristine, and it's intimidating. Sometimes it can be intimidating. So this is the final result. Have a great Holy Week, and if you find this video relaxing, if it makes you pray or meditate, or if you learn something, please consider subscribing to my channel. It's important for me. Thank you so much. Have a nice week and great Easter. Bye.